is also the common feature is this here. The chromosome has only one constriction. We call primary constriction. But the chromosome Drosera does not have this kind of structure. Only few species or only a few genus has this kind of type of chromosome. For example, in Drosera and Sipitang has this kind of chromosome. And Africa in Japan, this is highly protected and almost endangered species. And the Rotanifolia is a very popular species in the Northern Hemisphere. And the South species, the Spatulata, it have so many different morphology than some people say that Drosera spatulata have a complex. And then in Japan, we have two types of spatulata. First, called Kanto type, and second one is Kansai type. This is a Rotanifolia, and this is a Kanto type spatulata. And Kansai type have 20 equal 60. It's just this one plus this one equal this, something like this. Then, according to the distribution of these species, some scientists just think to the this Kansai type must be the hybrid origin between Rotanifolia and Kanto type spatulata. Anglica and Breakfolia, Chapiras, Piriformis, Hybrida, and Intermediate and Rotanifolia were used for further studies and just apply the semen and duct staining. The result is this. And it was some differentiation, we can see some chromosomal differentiation. Peritata, and this is Ranata, and this is Ordensis. The Ordensis have a dense white hair on the rib. And this is quite large chromosome. This is 3 times or 4 times bigger than Northern Hemisphere type of the chromosome. I make the gamma ray radiation. Then after this artificial fragment chromosome all should be survived. This is the reason why the, they have a polyploidation and the aneuploid species. Because of the localization of active centromere in the meiotic chromosome might make the species of Drosera very stable and promoted the polyploid speciation with the base chromosome number 10. This is my conclusion. Thank you very much for your attention.
The area has been burned recently, so I think I don't know whether I can still find my site of study. But you go to Sabah, you please climb up Mount Kinabalu. So we can see a lot of endemic species of pitcher plant on this mountain. Okay, next one. So this, you see, Sabah is, I think one thing about Sabah is because the topography, they have high mountains. My first intention is to know what is the species which can be found in this particular site that I study. And I want to know the density, population density of different species.
Very peculiar about this particular one, Nepenthes albo marginata. I study plot. Also, this is a very common species in Borneo. You can find it easily. And there are two types of features. As tell you now, this is the lower feature with the formula wing in front, and this is the upper feature. And then you can easily mistake with. Well, we say this is a different species. This is a different species. After they are which is a huge population of this Nepenthes bellosa, which is endemic also on the Atlantis of Mount Kinabalu. Next one. This is a Nepenthes alisa putriana that is described by me from Mount Kinabalu last 5 years, I think. It's, I said just now, endemic of Mount Kinabalu. So this is the famous Nepenthes raja. With I don't have the scale, but you can put the small cat inside it. So, next one, please. Kinabaluensis, Turata, Nepenthes kinabaluensis. This is Turata. Next one. Bichai, this is an epiphytic pitcher plant, which is found on the tree branch. Bichai, this is beautiful also for horticulturists, with a beautiful peristyle. The color is, it can be green or can be red. Next one, please. This is a micro vulgaris, which is mistaken by Kurata last 10 years. He said it's Nepenthes alata. It's described by Middleton in 1984, I think. It's endemic on limestone. Next one. This is a very common species on the high mountain. This Nepenthes tentaculata, a very common species. It's beautiful. You climb on the mountains in Borneo, you can gradually, they can marabilis, Nepenthes gradually, they can hybridize easily in the wild. I think it's easily hybridized.
Talk about Nepenthes in Malaysia. By using video.
Nepenthes. So, today. Very common species of Nepenthes gracilis. Nepenthes gracilis and Nepenthes gracilis. But sometimes three spots. This has the five spots. So variated honey grass. Nepenthes samplaria has the terrestrial pictures only.
Juga ada isinya.
Tapi isinya apa?
Thank you.